Our story today involves two companies. We'll just call them Taylor and Caldwell, and we'll represent them with these two people. Now, Caldwell owned a music hall in a park, and Taylor did concerts. Put music halls and concerts together, and what do you get? Caldwell then agrees to let Taylor to use their music hall for some concerts, and in exchange, Taylor agrees to pay Caldwell £100 per concert day. If you've watched our introductory video to contract law, you'd know that these agreements are called, in legal terms, contracts. You might also remember that the law is really serious about keeping contracts alive and making them happen. That's called the principle of sanctity of contract. But there's a question that I'd like you to consider at this point. How serious should the law be about making contracts happen? With that in mind then, let's return to our story. Now, the parties were quite chummy with each other and very happy with the arrangement. But all of a sudden, just 1 week before the first concert, the music hall burned down in a freak accident. No one expected that at all, and the two parties were probably quite sad about it. More importantly though, the contract between Taylor and Caldwell contained nothing to deal with this situation. And that meant that in the eyes of the law, the contract would still go on. That's exactly what Taylor argued. They wanted Caldwell to make amends for breaking their promise to provide them a music hall. Now imagine you're Caldwell in this situation. Sure, you promised to provide a music hall for Taylor, and it just burned down. So how could they still expect you to keep your promise? How could it be right? And so we return to the question, how serious should the law be about making contracts happen? Should they still force people to keep their promises when it becomes impossible to do so? Well, traditionally, the answer was yes. Taylor relied on the case of Paradine and Jane, which, believe it or not, was decided in 1647. In that case, a landlord rented out his land to a tenant, but the land was taken over by, I love this one so much, British Royalist forces. Then the landlord demanded that the tenant pay the rent for the time that the British Royalist forces had taken over the land. And believe it or not, the law sided with the landlord. Their contract would not be broken, even when the land was taken over by military forces. So, traditionally, the law was ultra serious about making contracts happen. That is, they were really serious about the principle of sanctity of contract. But the Paradine and Jane case was decided more than 200 years before the Taylor and Caldwell case, and the law had an opportunity to reconsider if it really wanted to be this harsh on contracting parties. So the case was heard by Justice Blackburn, who would later become a massive figure in legal history. He found that the parties must have agreed that if it became impossible for them to keep their promises, and no one was at fault for that, the promises would not have to be kept. That is, he found that there was an implied term in the contract that would discharge it once it became impossible to perform. Now, the Taylor and Caldwell case is often seen as a major turning point in the law, where the principle of sanctity of contract lost some of its harshness and made way for the doctrine of frustration. In the years to come, the law would continue developing the idea of frustration, while lawyers on the ground would start writing really long force majeure clauses to prevent contracts from being frustrated. But that's an academic debate that we will not be going down today. I really hope that this video was helpful for your understanding. A major thanks goes to Xiao Tong for the really awesome caricatures of Taylor and Caldwell. Please go check out her stuff with the link in the description. And of course, if you are a law student, the academic rabbit hole that I avoided today is exactly what you'll need to go down. So don't forget to do your readings. With all that said then, thank you so much for watching this video. Have a wonderful day ahead, and please, stay safe.